More weather updates here on the Weather Channel.
5 minutes past the top of the hour, Bruce Edwards has the scoop on the boat and beach report.
That's right, and all along, not too bad as far as boaters are concerned, with a couple of exceptions. One is into the Great Lakes with that front coming through. Winds over Lake Superior and Michigan at times are going to top 25 miles an hour. And that could also be the case later this afternoon over Lake Erie as the front approaches. But along the Atlantic seaboard, light winds generally. And sunshine will abound later on today from southern Connecticut and Long Island Sound down to the tidewater of Virginia, but very limited in the lakes with that front approaching. Sunshine also will be quite evident down to Little River Inlet and also over extreme south Florida. But with the Gulf and that showers and storms pushing eastward, and limited amounts of sunshine, occasionally gusty winds and thunderstorms. But overall, we're talking about light winds in the Gulf and the South Atlantic, as well as much of the Pacific coast. Until we get to Astoria, Oregon, there north we'll have winds about 15 to 25 miles per hour. And overall, we'll see sunny skies prevail across the western United States, with the exception of right along the immediate California coast and north into Oregon and Washington with the onshore flow. A few more clouds will hang in.
Doctors measure back pain by how far you can bend. Extra Strength Dones is made for back pain relief with an ingredient these pain relievers don't have. Dones makes back pain go away. Extra Strength Dones, made for back pain relief.
Six past the top of the hour. Time to say good morning, Carl.
Good morning, Liz, and good morning, everyone. As we check on your forecast, the western United States, fairly dry again for the midday hour. We do have that ridge of high pressure still in control across the west. A weak front will move toward the Puget Sound, maybe tonight, tomorrow morning, produce a few scattered showers. However, basically dry through the Rockies and the Plains states, where precipitation just not expected. Temperature-wise, again, on the hot side, 98 was a hot spot of the nation yesterday in Palm Springs. And looking at the 80s all the way into the Sacramento Valley towards Stockton and Sacramento, while 60s around Denver and into parts of Texas, temperatures in the 70s. The upper Midwest, a cool front will make its way through the area. The rain will begin to end later this morning, this afternoon around Chicago, and spread into South Bend and Toledo, Ohio, with more scattered showers pushing into Tennessee through today. However, the snow and the rain will be on the light side across the UP of Michigan and northern lower Michigan, with the temperatures of coolest up towards Alexandria in Minnesota at 40 and 60s and 70s across the Plain States. The northeast will basically dry for this morning. A few light snow flurries this morning around Concord, New Hampshire, but clouds are increasing as this system works its way towards New England. And a few sprinkles of rain heading towards parts of the Carolinas throughout the afternoon hours. As far as rain or snow, not much expected through New England with temperatures on the mild side, so maybe a nice day to take the lunch outside around Central Park on around the nation's capital, temperatures in the 60s. Southeast, one more nice day of great sunshine into the Carolinas and Georgia, but the moisture in the clouds are increasing as the afternoon wears on. Even parts of Florida could find a shower or a thunder shower. Heaviest of rain in parts of Texas were around Liberty and Montgomery counties. Some thunderstorms are producing 3 to 4 inches of rainfall there, and we have seen some beneficial rain for parts of southeastern Texas. 60s and 70s with the warmer temperatures in Florida. The big picture for this afternoon through tomorrow morning, looking at the eastern United States with the wet weather.
Instead of spending your weekend cutting the green, get a great weekend rate from Avis and save some green. Avis, we try harder to make it easier. How do you get a well-equipped late model Avis car with absolutely unlimited mileage, no matter how long you keep it? You buy it from Avis Car Sales. Avis, we try harder to make it easier.
The regional forecast. The 36-hour forecast.
1985, the mercury topped out at 100 degrees in Phoenix, Arizona. Now, that year, it was the earliest that high temperature had ever been recorded in Phoenix. Of course, last week, we shattered that record with topping out in triple digits many times over the weekend. Now, it's time to take a look at your business travel forecast. It's sponsored by Audi. Conform to the road, not the rule. Audi, the alternate route.
Left to take advantage of this special offer from AT&T. Listen.
If you're a business spending over $120 a month in long-distance services, and you think that you're saving 20 to 30% with another carrier, we want you to try AT&T Pro Watts. We'll waive the installation charges, waive the change charges, and if you're not satisfied and agree that we have the best value, price, and quality, at the end of 90 days, we'll pay to put you back on your other long-distance vendor. You can save 10 to 38% on AT&T long-distance.
And that's not all. With AT&T Pro Watts, no special lines or equipment are needed. Get distance-sensitive pricing. Get a detailed record of individual calls. And you save 10 to 38% on AT&T long-distance. Call 1-800-222-0400. Remember, we'll pay to switch you over. We'll pay the installation fee, and if you're not satisfied, we'll pay to switch you back. Call now. Pro Watts offer ends April 15th.
Stay tuned for the Days In 5-Day Business Planner, keeping track of storm systems, hazardous weather, and poor road conditions that may affect your business travel. The Days In 5-Day Business Planner, coming up in just a few minutes, right here on the Weather Channel.
In San Antonio, Texas today, and there's lots of festivals all across the country. Bruce has our weekend outlook.
Alrighty, we do, and for most of the country, it should be a pretty good looking weekend. We'll look at the jet stream right now, and we still see that ridge in the west. It is going to flatten a little bit, and that will allow some moisture to return to the northwest coastal region, but generally we'll still talk about dry weather across the west, while the trough in the east will continue to push a little bit of wet weather that is now in the plains to the Atlantic seaboard. Let's take a look at the specifics now. Temperatures, again, it can even heat up more across southern desert areas of California and Arizona into the triple digit figures. We'll see 90s up to Vegas and the 80s in the Central Valleys and the Great Basin, 70s and 60s into the northwest. While temperatures will still be quite mild and seasonable across much of the rest of the country on Saturday, but again, the soggy stuff up and down the Atlantic seaboard as that moisture rises to the northeast, showers, rain, maybe a thunderstorm over the extreme southeastern Gulf states, but the rest of the country dry on Saturday. And on Sunday, the west will remain dry, but we will see a little system draped across the Great Lakes again. So that means a threat of a few more showers, while South Florida and the coast of New England will have a mixture of some rain, possibly some snow up in the mountains. And temperatures will cool down with the clouds and the unsettled weather to the northeast, but the southern plains will warm up significantly with the 70s and 80s bowing northward. More triple-digit heat in the southwest.
Gee, Ollie, this windshield's so messy. I can't see. We need new wiper blades.
I know that.
Make sure your windshield wipers work when you need them. Get a new set of Anco blades at least once a year and see what you've been missing.
Ollie, without new Anco wipers, we could have been hit by that piano. Piano!
No!
Oh!
No matter what the weather, rain, sleet, or snow, Anco has the right wiper blade to see your way clear.
And to clear your way for travel today, here's Carl.
Well, most of the rough weather will probably be in parts of Texas and Louisiana. Big thunderstorms rolling through Corpus Christi this morning, producing an inch of rain in just 1 hour's time. Parts of Liberty and Montgomery counties reporting rainfall amounts of 3 to 4 inches. So we are finding some beneficial rains, especially for southeastern Texas, which finished 1988 about 20 inches below normal. Rainy weather in the lower Mississippi River Valley, parts of Florida, and up towards Michigan, we are finding a little bit in the way of wet weather. Strong thunderstorms a possibility here in parts of Texas, Louisiana, and even Florida, where yesterday a tornado was reported around Lakeland, Florida. Into the windy weather, the Great Lakes with that system scooting across, winds could be gusting up to 30 miles an hour. And patches of fog here and there in the northeast, parts of Texas, and the western seaboard, so take it slow and use the low beam. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Rubbermaid waste cans are built to withstand an accidental, an occasional, and still bounce back for more. Don't you wish everything was made like Rubbermaid?
We'll have the long-range forecast through Tuesday coming up in a few minutes. Right now, here's your local forecast sponsored by United Airlines, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve.
Make sure that business travel is it. That's why United offers the most service across the U.S. and the Pacific. United, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies.
Hey, Phil, I sure hope you haven't unpacked your bags yet, pal.
United Airlines, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies. For reservations, call United Airlines or your local travel agent.
Everyone, it's 19 minutes past the top of the hour on this Friday, April 14th. I'm here with Bruce Edwards and Carl Arredondo. Spring thunderstorms in Florida are blamed for spawning a tornado near Lakeland and Auburndale. The afternoon storms are also blamed for triggering the golf ball-sized hail. There are no reports of major damage or injuries. Snow showers have been falling this morning in portions of northern New England, and it's been freezing in portions of Maryland and Virginia. After pleasant weather conditions in the nation's capital Thursday, clear skies overnight have been letting that warmth escape back into the atmosphere. Yesterday, sunshine was perfect for a surprise visit from the Soviet national baseball team. The athletes met with President and Mrs. Bush on the south lawn of the White House. After a bout with winter-like weather across the southeast, spring returned. The afternoon break of sunshine in Jackson, Tennessee, shot the temperature up to 70 degrees. More typical spring weather is on tap through Saturday as thundershowers are in the forecast. While temperatures in the 70s are a warm change for the east, out west, the 74-degree reading in Los Angeles is significantly cooler than last week's record-breaking heat. Sunshine will be abundant through Saturday across the L.A. basin. Great time to get out and enjoy some of that sunshine. We invite you to stay tuned for the day's five-day business planner, America's Waking Up, today's inns, hotels, and suites. Here's Bruce Edwards.
As we take a look at the weather maps over the next 24 hours, not a whole lot of change in the west, although we will be watching this little front drop across British Columbia, and it'll be bringing some clouds to Washington and Oregon and a few light coastal showers, which is good news. It's been pretty dry for a while there. Major story, though, will be all this moisture into Texas and the lower Mississippi Valley. That'll be advancing into the east and phasing in with this front that'll be moving to the east. And what it'll spell is a little damp weather on the eastern third of the nation as we work our way on into tomorrow morning, with showers scattered about and maybe even a thunderstorm near the Gulf Coast and the Florida Panhandle tomorrow. High pressure going to clear things out of the lakes, cool things off again just a little bit. While the west, pretty tranquil, but there's that front finally making it some inroads, and that means a few scattered showers in the northwest. For today's highs, again, more heat in the west, no appreciable change here. 70s, 80s, and 90s dominating. We find seasonable readings in the southeast, but still a little cold up in Maine. Coldest weather tomorrow morning will be behind the front in the northern plains, lows dropping into the 20s there, but seasonably cool elsewhere. And then on Saturday, we'll see things begin to warm up a bit across the western plains while the cool air sweeps on to the east. The triple-digit heat will return again this weekend as portions of southern Arizona and California. But you notice how we get a wee bit of a cool food trend with some 50s and 60s in the northwest with some of the moisture, while the plain states really begin to heat up nicely on Sunday, and that continues to work its way generally towards the east. And by Tuesday, another system will bring some clouds and wet weather to the Great Lakes and a return to those cool 30 and 40 degree high temperatures, while much of the rest of the country will be fairly seasonable and cools down a bit on the northwest coast by Tuesday as well. Now there's your wet weather on Saturday with all that moisture showers from Maine to northern Florida. And then as we work our way into Saturday, another little system through the Great Lakes will again bring a mixture of some rain and snow in northern Michigan, but generally rain will be the ruling precipitation pattern. On Monday, a few sprinkles across the eastern portions of New York State, and another little system drops some showers into the plains. And again, the northwest will see some showers along the coast. And then by Tuesday, the system gains a little bit more moisture from the Gulf and slides east. And so that's where we'll have the wet weather and a persistent showery pattern over the northwest coast. Now let's update your regional weather.
Program restrictions do apply, and simple Super Saver rooms are limited, so call now. Well, lingering spring breakers in Florida may need the umbrella today. Carl will have the latest on the current weather after your local forecast.
If you're doing business, you probably have one of these, the American Express card. And if you're away from home to do that business, you're probably staying in one of these, Days Inns, Hotels, and Suites. Just last year, we saw over 2 million American Express card members at Days Inns, nearly twice as many as the year before. The way I see it, by next year, you'll have no business staying anywhere else.
Call 800-325-2525 for reservations at Days locations nationwide.
The regional forecast.
Channel 24 minutes past the top of the hour. Top side we go, and we'll check out the satellite view of the east. Watching parts of Texas, the lower Mississippi River Valley, that's where all the showers and thunderstorms will be for today. Still a little bit in the way of light rain and snow up towards New England, and another system bringing some light rain passing through Chicago. As we check out the western United States, here comes some more moisture, but overall not much in the way of a lot of precipitation until tonight and tomorrow morning, when we could find some showers around the Puget Sound. But across the southwest, again, very warm and with sunny skies. Underneath the clouds, we'll show you the radar map, and Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas finding most of the rain and showers and thunderstorms. Two local radar stops. First one will take us out of Marseille in Illinois. It's scattered light rain up towards Rockford and into parts of Chicago with some light rain. It's moving eastward. Next stop will take us out of West Palm Beach. Ground clutter around the radar side, but look offshore. Scattered showers and some thunderstorms here, and they're showing very little movement at the present time, but we could find a few scattered showers along the southern coast of Florida. As we check out the temperatures, not that bad. 59 in Burbank, 47 in Boise. With fairly dry weather, we have had some drizzle around North Bend, Oregon, but that's since ended. With the clouds here and there, the big system's offshore. It'll be moving on into parts of Washington later on tonight and tomorrow, bringing, again, the rain showers for tonight and tomorrow. Southwest dry and, again, warm until the upper Mississippi River Valley. That's where we're finding some rain. Around Chicago, on into Muskegon, Pelston, finding some rain also. We've had some snow this morning around International Falls with temperatures now just above the freezing mark. Chicago with some light rain at 46, 43 in Cincinnati. There's a cold front. It'll work its way on eastward, still bringing the rain as it presses through the Great Lakes. And some cooler air heading southward will bring temperatures today only in the 40s across northern Minnesota. Light snow around Bangor, Maine, and also around Burlington, Vermont. Portland with some light rain, but the snow will continue around Burlington for the next couple of hours as a weak system works its way eastward. Otherwise, high pressure and control with temperatures in Baltimore, 47 this morning, around Toledo at 41, 35 in Buffalo. And there are the clouds with the system as it works its way eastward, even some clouds around the Green and White Mountains. To the south, that's where all the showers and thunderstorms are. Some of the rain has been heavy. Around Kingsville, almost 3 inches of rain. Stephenville, over 2. Corpus Christi, 1.75 inches. Very welcome rain in parts of South Texas that are very, very dry. San Antonio, 54 with some light drizzle. 56 in Atlanta, Georgia. And rain pushing into Memphis, Tennessee, and Blytheville in Arkansas. The big picture, once again, if you're heading out to the airports this morning, reporting no delays in the east. However, in the western United States, we are reporting some delays around Dallas and Fort Worth with some drizzle, light rain, and low ceilings. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Just think of having the convenience of a copier and a fax machine right in your office. Not enough space? Too much money? Not anymore. With the Murata M1200, you've got a high-speed fax machine, an office copier, and a full-feature telephone in one compact, low-cost unit that takes up less space than a standard typewriter. With the Murata M1200 fax, phone, and copier, you won't be losing time traveling back and forth to a copy fax center. And the M1200 is so inexpensive, you can afford to keep one at home for those rare occasions when you've left an important document behind. Like all Murata products, the M1200 is reliable and backed by great service and support. For a limited time, the Murata M1200 fax, phone, and copier is specially priced at only $675. Call MJP at 1-800-937-9393 now for complete details with no obligation. That's 1-800-937-9393 for more information about the Murata M1200 fax, phone, and copier. Call now.
The current conditions.
Good morning with our forecast and Bruce Edwards.
Thank you, Liz, and good morning, everyone. It's going to be a pretty nice day across the western U.S. What else is new? You've sort of gotten used to the pleasant weather. It's been rather cool the last few days because of the marine layer hanging into the L.A. Basin, and that's kept the clouds overhead. But that's going to be relinquishing somewhat, and we'll get a little more of a flow off the desert, so a little warmer temperatures for today. And look at this. A front appears on the horizon. That'll be approaching the northwest coast and could bring a threat of some light showers through the course of the weekend. But for today, coastal drizzle about the best you can hope for. Otherwise, dry, sunny weather will prevail with temperatures again in the 80s and 90s in the southwest, 80s Sacramento and San Joaquin Valley. And look at those 70s just about encompassing the entire western third of the nation. Looking very comfortable. Upper Midwest will see some colder northerly winds, a little snow in the upper Midwest, and the showers accompanying this front will be very light and widely scattered. No real significant rains until we get into portions of lower Michigan. You might see a tenth of an inch to a half an inch, but most of the rain is light, and the snows are light as well. Might see an inch or so in the upper peninsula and the Keweenaw Peninsula of Michigan, with the cooler air behind the front, but a pleasant spring afternoon ahead of the front with 60s and 70s for afternoon highs through the plains into the Ohio River Valley. There's the front again coming through Michigan. It'll be bringing some increasing clouds and rather gusty winds out of the southwest ahead of the front, but again, it's out of the proper direction, so that'll warm things up. While high pressure over the northeast will continue to work on out, we'll see some clouds increasing ahead of the system, but generally a dry day across the New England states. And we're talking about some comfortable temperatures overall, with 50s into the lakes, 60s Ohio Valley and mid-Atlantic, but still cold in northern New England with 30s and 40s. To the southeast now, scattered thunderstorms with a stationary front in central Florida, but that Gulf moisture riding into Texas now spreading northeast with clouds on the increase this afternoon into Georgia and South Carolina. For the heaviest rains, Texas, Louisiana Gulf Coast with an inch or perhaps even a bit more. Seasonable temperatures in the 70s and 80s. The big picture again shows that that moisture spreads rapidly east overnight tonight and tomorrow morning with scattered rains from New York State south to the Gulf Coast, but the rest of the country will remain dry.
This is it. Your day in the sun. You've got talent, experience, and equipment you can depend on. Charcoal made with premium woods to bring power and consistency to your game. Then, and only then, can you bask in the glow of victory. Kingsford Charcoal, what the pros use.
The current conditions. The 36-hour forecast.
Before the top of the hour now, wondering what the forecast is like for 18 major cities across the country? Wonder no longer. Now it's time for your business travel forecast, sponsored by United Airlines, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Here's today's forecast. Just in case you missed your favorite city, here's Carl.
Thank you, Liz. As we check on the big picture, first of all, and looking at the south, that's where all the showers and thunderstorms will be for today. A few light showers and some drizzle from St. Louis on northward to Detroit later by the midday hour as the system works its way eastward very slowly. The eastern seaboard fairly dry, but clouds increasing in the southeast. The southwest dry and warm again, and the clouds will increase in the northwest with that system offshore. Temperatures not that bad across the nation. The 40s and the 50s across the extreme north, the 90s, and maybe one or two 100s in the southwest, but 60s and 70s across much of the southeast and the lower Mississippi River Valley. Stay tuned. Coming up, some weather highlights and a look at the current weather with an action radar out of Galveston.
Great, Ray. That's a wrap.
California Raisin display in your favorite store and send for your California Raisin figurine.
Regional forecast. The 36-hour forecast.
Everyone, it's 22 minutes before the top of the hour. I'm here with Carl Arredondo and Bruce Edwards. Marine biologists say contamination from the Alaskan oil spill may remain in the environment for up to 10 years. The state's Environmental Conservation Commissioner says the area will never be the same. The weather hasn't been the same out west over the past week. In California, residents are enjoying a cool break after last week's heat wave. In Los Angeles, Thursday's high temperature only reached 74 degrees. A welcome change from last week's triple-digit heat that claimed two lives. Sunshine will remain abundant in the L.A. Basin through Saturday. In Jackson, Tennessee, temperatures in the 70s are a definite warm-up from their bout with wintry weather at the start of the week. More spring-like conditions are in the forecast with a threat of thunder showers through Saturday. Thunderstorms have been booming in southeast Texas, while strong storms in Florida Thursday afternoon are blamed for spawning a tornado and triggering golf ball-sized hail between Lakeland and Auburndale. A series of winter-like storms in the northeast have had little effect on the mid-Atlantic and the southeastern states. Plenty of sunshine in Washington, D.C. greeted members of the Soviet national baseball team Thursday for their visit with the Bushes. Coming up now on 21 before the top of the hour, time to take a look at Waking Up Weather, sponsored by Mountain Grown Folgers Coffee. Folgers, the best part of waking up. Here's Carl.
Thank you, Liz. As we check on the satellite view, the parts of Texas and the lower Mississippi River Valley fighting most of the showers and thunderstorm activity here as the rainfall amounts total between 3 to 4 inches in parts of Liberty and Montgomery County, while the eastern United States on the dry side as we are finding some rain showers into parts of the Great Lakes region, but that's just on the light side. As we check the west, very dry across the southwest, maybe a little bit in the way of some fog here and there, but some drizzle this morning in North Bend, Oregon, the bigger system offshore, and that'll make its way inland into the Puget Sound by tonight and tomorrow morning. As we look at the radar map, showers and thunderstorms in the lower Mississippi River Valley, some light rain into the Great Lakes around Chicago, and also some light rain and some snow in sections of Maine. One radar stop, well, we don't have that radar stop. Well, let's go on to the western United States. We're looking at the dry conditions across the western seaboard. We had some drizzle this morning in North Bend, Oregon. Temperatures not that bad. 47 in Salt Lake City, 37 in Billings, and also 59 around Burbank. Clouds in the northwest, but clear, and it's going to be warm in the southwest. Next system right here in the upper Mississippi River Valley, and the showers and thunderstorms across the south. We got one action radar. Let's show you the radar out of Galveston, Texas, as we find the showers and thunderstorms advancing eastward. Parts of Liberty and Montgomery County finding quite a bit in the way of rainfall. Houston with some showers this morning. College Station, big thunderstorms rolled through Corpus Christi and produced 1 inch of rain in 1 hour's time, and they continue to advance on eastward. As we check out the situation again, at the temperatures, 50 in Dallas, some light drizzle in San Antonio, 54 for the beginning of Fiesta Week, a damp start, but most of the week should be nice. 56 in Atlanta, Georgia, 49 in Nashville, Tennessee. Rain already at Memphis, Blytheville, and Harrison, Arkansas. And the showers and thunderstorms continue in Texas and Louisiana. Some of the rainfall amounts have been heavy around Kingsville, Texas. 2 3/4 of an inch of rain, over 2 inches in Stephenville, Texas. Corpus Christi, 1 3/4 inches. And also San Antonio with over an inch of rainfall. The Great Lakes, here comes the next system, producing some rain around Traverse City on into Chicago, Muskegon, Michigan. Some light snow around Brunswick, Maine, with Portland, some light showers. Temperatures there near the freezing mark, 36 in Bangor, Maine, 44 in Boston, 35 in Buffalo. There's a system there, and still some low clouds into sections of New England. And with the front here, we have found some snow this morning around International Falls. Temperatures now just above the freezing mark. Chicago at 46 degrees, and we're looking at 48 in Springfield. Cincinnati at 43, and Scotts Bluff, Nebraska at 31. There's a frontal system right there as it works its way eastward. Continue to produce a little bit in the way of some light rain, but we're not expecting accumulation to be very much. Maybe 1 to 3 inches of snow in the northern UP of Michigan, and the showers towards Oklahoma City, Harrison, and moving into the Volunteer State. There's a look at the big picture once again. The West dry and again very warm in the Southwest. The nation's hot spot yesterday was 98 in Palm Springs, California. Showers and thunderstorms could be strong, could produce some small hailstones and gusty winds. And Florida even can see a scattered shower or thunderstorm for today. The airports this morning, no delays in the east, but in the west, with the rain and the drizzle, low ceilings, some delays in Dallas. Stay tuned. Coming up, your good morning forecast.
It's your 30th birthday, girl. Is it hard to face the world? But there's still just to brew that aroma's calling.
You are finally waking up.
The best part of waking up.
Caffeinate?
It's Folgers in your cup.
Wake up with Mountain Grown Folgers Decaffeinated. Mountain Grown beans have a more enticing aroma and richer flavor.
It's Folgers in your cup.
Responsive. The CAT computer is a superior IBM compatible personal computer with all the features you want at a price that makes buying a CAT easy. The CAT computer has 640K RAM, a 20 megabyte hard disk, a color monitor, a full keyboard, and even a mouse. The CAT computer runs all the terrific word processing, accounting, and graphics software. With a CAT computer, you can finally afford the computing power you've always wanted. To get all these features anywhere else, you'd have to spend as much as $4,000 or more. Through this special limited offer, NGP Federated is offering the CAT computer for just $999. And remember, that includes a color monitor, a mouse, and a 20 megabyte hard disk. Call the toll-free number on your screen for a free brochure. Call 1-800-937-9393 today for the powerful, affordable CAT computer.
Day forecast. Stay tuned for more weather coverage here on the Weather Channel.
15 minutes before the top of the hour now, and Bruce is standing by with our good morning forecast.
Hey, indeed I am, and good morning, everyone. TGIF, it's a Friday, and a good-looking Friday. You might want to work half a day today and make it an extra long weekend, because it's going to be pleasant over the west. Again, nothing different than what you've seen in the last several days, except a few less clouds across Southern California and a little warmer temperatures. But we'll be watching this little front lurking offshore. That will be moving on late tonight and tomorrow, and that'll bring a chance for a few showers to the northwest coast. Now, we've got intermittent drizzle right now, but it's not going to amount to anything whatsoever just along the coast. We're looking at warmth again through the interior with 70s, 80s, and again 90s in the southwest, continuing to dominate the regime. However, right along the immediate coast, we'll see some readings in the 70s, but still that's very comfortable. Upper Midwest, we'll see another clipper racing into the Great Lakes, and behind it, colder air, a little of snow in upper Michigan, while along the frontal boundary, some scattered, mostly light rain showers from Michigan through the mid-Mississippi Valley. But the only significant accumulation will be in the vicinity of the lakes where the moisture is available, maybe a tenth to half an inch of rain, closer to a tenth than a half an inch. Temperatures will cool down into the 40s again across northern Minnesota, but ahead of the front, look at those 60s and some 70s into the central and southern plain states, looking comfortable. High pressure keeping the east quiet for the day today. We'll put an end to the light rain and drizzle, and the patchy fogs burning off rapidly. But as the front approaches, we'll see an increase in cloud cover over the eastern Great Lakes states today. And again, some showers pushing in towards, say, Toledo, Ohio late this afternoon, Fort Wayne, Indiana. But generally, light amounts of rain that are not going to amount to all that much at all. Dry through New England, and temperature is going to be mild with that southwesterly wind flow. We'll see the 60s bubbling up towards Williamsport, Pennsylvania, through much of New Jersey, 50s into southern New England. So fairly seasonable temperatures here. Same story in the Ohio Valley, those 60s running from Dayton, Ohio, through Columbus to Zanesville to Huntington, West Virginia. Scattered thunderstorms into Florida, but most of the moisture, East Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, and Mississippi, and that will begin to ride northeastward as the day progresses. And the most substantial rains likely to be found along the Texas and Louisiana Gulf Coast, an inch or so there, half an inch up towards Memphis, Tennessee, and scattered amounts of a tenth to a half an inch across central and south Florida with those afternoon thunderstorms. Temperatures seasonable in the region, 70s and 80s, the dominant reports coming out this afternoon. That's your weather picture by late afternoon or early tomorrow morning. We see the rain advancing along the Atlantic seaboard. The front will bring a few sprinkles to the Pacific Northwest, dry elsewhere.
This year, thousands of people who thought they bought a house paint that would last, and last, and last, will discover what they really got for their money. The wrong paint. Make sure you get the right paint. Durable Glidden Spread House Paint, a paint that really lasts. On sale now for a low price that won't. Glidden, your paint should be this good.
A heavy thunderstorm you're seeing towards the Sabine River Valley, and the clouds increasing over Alabama right now. They'll be spreading over the southeast with the rain shortly thereafter. Here's a look at some rainfall totals in Texas over the last 24 hours, and we see Kingsville picked up 2 3/4 inches of rain. Stephenville almost over 2 inches of rain there. Corpus Christi, 1 79 hundredths, and a lot of that came with some very heavy thunderstorms just a little earlier this morning. San Antonio, over 1 inch of rain reported. And the outlook for the next 24 hours ending at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning is for an additional inch along the Texas-Louisiana coast, a half an inch to an inch up towards Memphis, and some of the foothills and the Appalachians, the rain will be falling, and most of this will occur later on tonight and early tomorrow morning. You'll have a higher likelihood of moisture through that region of the country. So, again, it's going to be spreading. Now, a little snow, as we mentioned, upper Midwest, but just a light dusting of maybe.
You have lots of rain.
System works its way offshore. Temperature-wise, still not a big change through Saturday and Sunday. Stay tuned. Your Michelin Drivers Report coming up.
It's deer season. Time to drive a bargain with your John Deere dealer. Now you can get $100 to $300 off on riders and tractors. Or choose accessories at no extra cost. But hurry, deer season ends May 31st. See your John Deere dealer and drive home a bargain.
See the complete line of lawn and garden equipment at your local authorized John Deere dealer.
Five before the top of the hour. Thanks for joining us. Stay tuned. We'll have much more with John Doyle, Sarah Lemke, and Bill Schubert. But right now, time for the Michelin Drivers Report. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires. Bruce?
Thank you, Liz. Once again, very damp across eastern Texas and on into Louisiana. Showers are extending into Arkansas and now reaching into Mississippi and western sections of Tennessee. So I-55, Interstate 30, 45, and especially Interstate 10 will be quite wet. There will definitely be showers throughout the course of the day, and that rain will be expanding east as the day progresses. Scattered showers in the Florida Peninsula today. Maybe even a few strong storms across the eastern Gulf states of Texas and on into Louisiana and across central sections of Florida, so be ready for that. With a front and a low pressure cell whipping through the Great Lakes, wind gusts down to Chicagoland will be topping 30 miles an hour from time to time. The fog is beginning to lift in the northeast, but there's still a few patchy areas through New Jersey and also along the...
But don't panic, because the houses are gone.
Watch Calm the Catastrophe to learn how you and your family can increase your chances of survival and how to deal with the emotional impact when catastrophe strikes. Don't miss this special presentation, Calm to Catastrophe, this weekend on the Weather Channel. The current conditions. Weather coverage here on the Weather Channel. Now, the morning report with John Doyle.
Good Friday morning from the Weather Channel. Cheryl Lemke is here along with Bill Schubert.
And some interesting surprises for the weekend outlook. You might like it, Cheryl.
Some low clouds, drizzle, and fog plaguing parts of the West Coast this morning, but that should be giving way to lots of sunshine this afternoon. John?
Rainfall totals in the west are as easily as much as 8 inches below normal, with just a chance of some drizzle by tomorrow in northwest Washington state. High pressure.
Some light rain showers moving across Louisiana, down into Memphis, Tennessee. And later on in this segment, we'll look at local radar out of Memphis. But first of all, we'll check those clouds again as they move across Oklahoma into the lower Mississippi Valley. Meanwhile, in the northeast, a little white snow as a cold front begins to move in across northern Michigan, and a little white snow falling at Burlington, Vermont. But the northwest continues to be dry. These clouds here, nothing more than high cirrus clouds. Okay, what about the airports? Any delays being reported at these six airports? Aha! Dallas-Fort Worth, a 40-minute delay because of some rain and fog. Temperatures out west, Seattle, Washington, 50 degrees. Almost didn't get that word out. San Francisco at 56. Salt Lake City and Boise both at 47. Just a lot of high cirrus clouds around. And, of course, down in the Los Angeles Basin at San Diego, they're looking at 62 along with cloudy skies. And the weather is dry out west. Even the fog is gone for the most part. A little bit of low clouds in the Los Angeles Basin. A few scattered showers in North Dakota. The northwest covered with on deck a high cirrus cloud. And around the four corners of the southwest, looking high and dry. It is cold from bringing slightly cooler air, but it's not a big deal. And again, there is rain out in the Pacific, but it's not going anywhere because of this big ridge of high pressure. But eventually, this storm out here may make it onshore early next week to bring a chance for some more important rain. But we'll have to just live with the dry weather for the time being. As we go further to the east over the Rockies, well, here's the cold front here, bringing with it clouds, a little bit of light rain, but the heaviest rains, of course, down into the south. International Falls, Minnesota had 34 degrees above freezing, melting the snow. Bismarck at 39. Minneapolis, bare skies at 43, and as we head to Marquette, Michigan, cloudy, 36. They had a little rain earlier. It's been raining on and off at Grand Rapids, Michigan at 39. Springfield, Illinois, bare skies at 48. There's the front. It's really not doing a heck of a lot, bringing a little light rain into northern Illinois. Chicago gets some raindrops, as well as Grand Rapids, Michigan, as I just mentioned. And Traverse City, Michigan, a little rain and some ice pellets and snow mixed in from time to time. Then the northeast, it's a dry morning. It's kind of cloudy over central and eastern New England. Clear skies, but the high clouds are beginning to increase in western New York. 35 with some high cirrus clouds now beginning to cover the sky a little bit. In Buffalo, Albany at 38. Boston looking good at 44. Let's see, Tanger, Maine, 32nd, Baltimore, Maryland. Pretty nice day shaping up, already up to 47 degrees. Well, here's high pressure. We're getting a little snow, though, kind of a little bit of a trough of low pressure over northern New England. Light rain at Portland, Maine. Light snow at Burlington, Vermont, inland. Earlier, Concord and Laconia, New Hampshire, had a little bit of light snow. New York City looking just fine, and to the south, no problems at all. There's a satellite picture showing the clouds across much of the New England states, the thicker clouds, bringing the rain and snow out across Michigan. The southeast looking fine this morning. 70 already in Tampa. Miami already 80 degrees. Oh, I'm jealous about that. Nashville at 49, Little Rock 56, New Orleans, a lot of high clouds at 61 degrees. And the weather map, well, here's the frontal system. Nothing going on in Florida, but that could change later. The showers in Texas, Dallas, down to Corpus Christi, and northeast into Memphis, Tennessee. Lots of clouds here as we enhance it. Looks nasty out in the Gulf of Mexico, and with good reason. It is. A lot of showers and storms out here. Okay, here's a look at the national weather map again, and the radar. It's a busy one in the south. We have two local radars to show you. The first out of Memphis, Tennessee, indicating rain showers here, moving to the east-northeast at about 25. Our second stop will take us into Longview, Texas, or Shreveport, Louisiana. Showers here, moving off to the east at 25.
I love you.
Champagne is now being served on the after deck.
By the way, when will your inheritance come through?
Lobster is now being served on the promenade deck.
I love your villa at Monte Carlo.
Colombian coffee is now being served in the starboard side lounge.
No wonder so many people's preferences lean toward 100% Colombian coffee. It's the richest coffee in the world, and picked by Juan Valdez.
Seashore, maybe catch a little fish for Bill. Yeah, certainly you're not going to get any sun or, well, you could get a suntan in the northeast day, sure, but it's too cold to sit down on the beach, but to go out fishing, looking great. The winds are light, by the way, from York, Maine, down to Cape Hatteras, North Carolina, and go out and catch a fish. Flounder in the northeast, cod and pollock offshore. Hey, maybe the Boston mackerel coming in pretty soon. I used to live up in near Connecticut there and caught a lot of those Boston mackerel. Stronger winds across the Great